just got me thinking. On that cap, swerving through traffic, listening to traffic. My windows ain't tinted. I'm everywhere comfortable, but I'm still attentive. A young with money will make offended. I ain't flashy, I'm classy, but I ain't stupid either. Never show up to that's hungry and eager. My brother's keeper, I'm loyal, it's all in my demeanor. A true believer, I believe when they didn't believe her. That's why I don't let opinions affect me. I do what I wanna do. If they do or they don't accept me, they expect me to give up. I almost did. Things went from moving fast to slow motion. I was losing focus, stuck on that. It was smooth on the surface, but underneath it was broken. Hoping to find hope in this hopeless world we live in. What you give is what you're given. Gotta make wise decisions, gotta stay tunnel vision. Gotta avoid collision, keep scratching the surface and keep your palms itching. Gotta pay moms a visit, it's been a while. I've been working, she keep telling me she miss her child. I find myself passing the house, then I spin around. She say I'm always moving, ma, I just can't sit around. Oh my, cause the cash ain't gon' come to us. When we was down, who gave a dime or gave a for us? So instead of making it hard, I made it fun for us. Make it easy, so when you need it, you just run to us. But it's a lot of pressure, I'm trying to stick and move through this. Fixing these bumps on the road so I can just cruise to this. Living my life on the road, I'm trying to get used to this. And when they throw dirt, I just act like a broom to this. Trying to stay true to this. Even when they lie on me, world on my shoulders, my girl can't even cry on me. God watching over me, the devil probably spy on me. I've been going through some, Kenneth keep an eye on me. I know it's been a drought, but to my fans, don't go dry on me. If you want a picture, take a picture, don't get shy on me. I'm here to inspire, I admire that you admire me. I've been in the dark, but I promise you'll see a bright of me. I'm sorry. To all my supporters, man, I love y'all. I just want to say thank you for supporting me since day one. You don't want to see me win, man. I don't know why, but we gonna win anyway. It came straight out the with a microphone. Boy, I swear I couldn't leave that mic alone. Everybody clear the room, I like to write alone. I'm in my zone, bass bouncing off the styrofoam. I'm never in between, I'm either hot or cold. Can't be a loser, I maneuver like I got a clone. I'm out here in these streets like I ain't got a home. And you barely hear from me like I ain't got a phone. Cause there's no days off, there's no days off. I know it sounds a little painful, but it pays off. Social sites was distracting, so I stayed off. Spoke to God, then me and Satan had a face off. I swear my life was like a rocket, then it takes off. First I plotted, then I got it, couldn't wait long. I put the pedal to the metal, then took the brakes off. And I kept it A1 like the steak sauce. My paychecks used to be a pair of Jordans, and I know I can't afford them, but I went ahead and bought them. Then I quit, started, spent my money on recording. Yeah, the studio was small, but man, that made me a fortune. Made me a fortune, man. Trying to stop me. Y'all can't stop me. This is forever. Forever, man. I mean that. It's one of them ones, man. You just in the car, man. It's like when you in the car, you just think about everything, man. Definitely when you like you by yourself and you just cruising on the highway, man. Yeah, this got me thinking. On that cap, swerving through traffic, listening to traffic. My windows ain't tinted, so notice me. For a braids, Yankee fitted, yeah, know it's me. I'm everywhere comfortable, but I'm still attentive. A young with money will make offended. I ain't flashy, I'm classy, but I ain't stupid either. Never show up to that's hungry and eager. My brother's keeper, I'm loyal, it's all in my demeanor. A true believer, I believe when they didn't believe her. That's why I don't let opinions affect me. I do what I wanna do.
Hello, everybody. I'm Jonathan Coachman, and this is Super Bowl Sunday on EA Sports.
All right, Coach, thank you very much. It's the National Football League presented by EA Sports. Tonight, it's all on the line. We play for the Lombardi Trophy. 50 years after Joe Namath and the guarantee, we are underway in Super Bowl 53. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And the decision to bring it out is going to cost him about 7 yards all told as he's taken down back shy of the 20. Is Garoppolo, and he fires one that's intercepted, picked off at the 14, and he will bring it back. It's a pick six and a Dolphins touchdown. Striking first in any game is very important, but on this stage, the biggest of stages in the Super Bowl, that's huge.
You fully expect the other team to battle all the way through, but when you're the one setting the pace, jumping out in front, that has to feel great for the entire organization.
Extra point up and good by Sanders, and it's now a 7-0 game. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. And the 49ers getting set to trot out there. Garoppolo going to bring the Niners up here first and 10 at their own 19-yard line.
Here we go. Wait, 80!
Now the Georgia Southern man, it's Matt Breida. And nothing doing on his first run. Back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. No gain on the play there, second down. And this O-line, it is the lifeblood of the offense.
They established the... tone. Mean, nasty, physical. They can't wait to get after people. That allows the rest of the offense to feel confident.
Garoppolo to throw on second down. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. And the offense will cover this one up, but they'll be put. Back inside their own 10. After the sack, they'll come up now, third and long.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised to see them run the ball here just to try and get some space.
Four down.
No run call here. They'll look to throw instead. He's got a man complete. He's at the 40. 20. 10. Touchdown, 49ers. Marquise Goodwin, 92 yards. And the 49ers are within an extra point of tying this thing up. Well, go ahead and strap in, partner. Less than 2 minutes in, had the score on the one side. A quick answer, though, to get the equalizer.
Sometimes you get that sense of urgency that ratchets up, right? When you give up an early touchdown like that, you just know you're like, okay, how do we go back and equalize things? Can we get it done fast? And they absolutely did. Essentially, we're back to even, aren't we?
So we're right back where we started. All even as the kick's away. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have stayed where he was as he'll only get back to the 16-yard line. Tannehill and the Dolphins break the huddle. Come up first and 10 at their own 16.
Set, ready.
Tannehill. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
The beauty of being able to play a zone defense, when you can sit back and see the ball coming out of the quarterback's hands, guess what? Creates a lot of confusion, kind of a muddle in the middle of the field where you can go make a play on the football.
Lady!
On second and 10, Tannehill. And he hits his target. It's Kenny Stills. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down. A good pickup there, 26 yards. They go play action here on first down. And his throw is incomplete. He was trying to get that one to Kenny Stills. And that'll bring up second down. That's already the third time they've looked his way on this opening drive. He's caught one of the three.
But that doesn't mean they won't continue to go in that direction. It feels like they think they've got something good going there, and they think those numbers are going to increase.
Back to the air, Tannehill on second down. Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the former Super Bowl MVP, Malcolm Smith. And his guys are going to get the football at their own 47-yard line.
Yeah, he's just trying to throw this ball into the hole in the zone, but those windows can open and close quickly, especially in the middle of the field. So if the timing's not right, we'll see interceptions like that one right there.
By 20!
So after the INT, it's Garoppolo. The first catch of the game for George Kittle. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. Solid way to start the drive, 13 yards, picking up the first.
A lot of tight ends just use their size and their strength, try to occupy some space and kind of body people away and catch the football. But not this guy. He's a refined route runner. Makes me wonder if he took some dance classes in his background with his footwork.
Here's Breida. Looking to find a lane, but he can't, reined in at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play. It'll be second down.
Doubling this guy has to be a priority before moving up to the next level, because the big fella, he just ate that one alive, just stuffed it. In fact, before the game, he was talking to us, and he's like, hey, these pants make me look fat? And we said, nah, man, you're just a whole lot of guy.
He is at well over 300 pounds. He's a big man. Now Garoppolo throwing on second. And he whips that one incomplete there. He was trying to get it to George Kittle. It's tight end. Third down here. Before the game, they were running the route tree about as efficiently and effectively as we could have possibly imagined. But sometimes the passes just go awry.
Yeah, let's face it. When you're running the route tree in pregame, you don't have defenders breathing down your neck. You don't have defensive backs making plays on the football. Hard to replicate the intensity of the game in pregame.
Throwing is Garoppolo on third down. Open man is Taylor. He's got it. And he doesn't quite make it, taking it within an eyelash. Dropped at the one. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. A nice job there, Charles. They picked up the blitz. We're able to complete the pass.
That had the total feel of a quarterback in control. Red blitz got him into the right protection scheme, so he doesn't get hit back there. He's got a chance to step up with supreme confidence and deliver it downfield for a nice completion.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
That one didn't quite make it to the target, but that's not always a function of the strength of the arm of the quarterback, is it? Sometimes there's just too much pressure there. In any case, the ball doesn't arrive.
Another shot from the one on second and goal. They'll try to run with Breida. And this time he's going backwards. So after the no gain on the last attempt, here they get him behind the line.
That's a really alert defense there, because they saw the heavy look come in from the offense, countered it with extra linebackers who brought a little bit of speed and heft, and able to really make a big-time play for their defense.
Garoppolo now on third and goal. Hard throw, incomplete.
You hear the calls for a penalty, but I just don't think so. I think in this situation, the defender is making sure his guy couldn't hold on to the football. So I don't see anything to warrant the flag.
No, I'm with you. There was contact, but I'm happy they kept that flag in the back pocket. And this may be a big early turning point in this Super Bowl. They're going to go for it on fourth down here. They come out here in the eye. Garoppolo going to go on fourth down. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Picked off by Bobby McCain. And he will bring it out past the 20-yard line.
Brandon, this is why golfers do their best to never count a score in their head before the ball goes in the cup. This looked like a slam dunk for points on this drive, didn't it? Instead, they throw an interception, and they're going to come away empty.
After the interception, here's Tannehill. His throw incomplete. Kenny Stills, the intended receiver, and it's second down.
It's always a battle. Who's going to win on first down, the offense or the defense? Let's face it, if you've got the ball, 4 yards or more on first down is what you're aiming for. They tried to throw for it there. Nice effort to knock that one away and bring up second down.
30.
Second and 10. Tannehill once more. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by Quan Williams. And into the end zone. A pick six for the 49er D as they score the touchdown. I don't know who all is to blame there, but I love seeing pick sixes.
Nothing like seeing someone pluck it out of the air and go the other way and see people try to change directions. Hard to do.
Gold with the extra point, and that makes the score 14-7. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And the decision to bring it out, a good one, as he's up a yard or two shy of the 30. So now here come the Dolphins. And job one here, Charles, just keep possession of the football. Two drives, two turnovers to this point.
You're exactly right, Doctor. Hippocratic oath, first do no harm. And right now they're harming themselves on offense.
I like that. No one is mistaking me for a doctor, though. But thank you, Dr. David. Now it's Gore. And he powers his way up past the 30. It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down.
I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable second down. A very solid gain on that play.
To throw on second down is Tannehill. And here's another interception, the third of this first quarter. Picked off by the former Super Bowl MVP, Malcolm Smith. And into the end zone, a pick six for the 49er D as they score the touchdown. Short throw pick six right there, those linebackers. They love when those short throws come and those eyes get real wide, don't they?
How about the anticipation on the play? Reading, reacting, and then the ability to catch the football and take it in the opposite direction.
Gold able to tack on the extra point, and it's now 21-7. A heck of a play there defensively, getting the interception, navigating his way into the end zone for the touchdown. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And he'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line. Tannehill and the Dolphins break the huddle. Come up first and 10 at their own 26.
Hey, four down.
Fresh off the pick six, it's Tannehill. They're complete. This is Albert Wilson. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. And they've got it here with a first down. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10.
Even.
Now a play fake here on first down. And down he goes. The 49ers get there. Solomon Thomas, he's the one that got to him. He takes him down for a loss of 9.
Well, someone's been up to the task so far in this game. They are already up a couple of scores, Brandon. And guess what? I think they're just going to pin their ears back now and get upfield and get after the quarterback.
Been such an impressive first half to get that lead. On second down, here's Tannehill. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. They get 11 back on that one. It leads to third down.
All that practice time came to fruition on that play. All those timing routes that they work on through training camp, OTAs, minicamp, and just regular season, they got it done on that one. An outcut, ball was delivered, and picked up the completion.
On play action, Tannehill. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. It's the former Seahawk, Richard Sherman. And they take possession of the football and have it at the 36-yard line. We haven't even escaped the first half, and he's already thrown four picks.
And Brandon, back in the good old days, probably back before you were born, if your starter threw four in the first half, he might throw eight or more for the game because they weren't going to pull him out. But nowadays, the patience level isn't quite there. He's going to have to make some real adjustments, or the backup may see some time.
Here we go. 180.
They'll start on the ground with Breida. And he's across the 40 for the extra yards to the 43. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice, solid gain. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits and leaves creases like they were able to exploit right there.
Hey, boys, we got four down.
White 20, black 80.
27, Mike, 27.
On second down, here's Garoppolo. Complete to the right, this is Garcon. He'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. Garcon with his first grab, good enough for a first down.
Well, if you do read man coverage, Brandon, the drag route's a pretty good one to run against it because you're running away from people on it.
Toss play, it's Breida. And a pretty big hole as he's down to about the 40. He'll get a nice chunk there on the...
down run, and it's 2nd and 4.
Let's talk a little football 101 here, because one of the keys to advancing the ball downfield, success on first down. Huge difference, as we know, between 2nd and 4 and 2nd and 8 and 9.
Check 4.
180.
52 is the mic, right here, over there, right?
52
is the mic.
Now it's Breida. And he'll take this one down to about the 40. Just a gain of a...
yard there, and now it'll be third down.
Well, he hasn't made much of an impact in the running game thus far, and after that last run, not much.